Legends of SKT. The players may change. The pedigree stays the same. If you join SKT, you are very likely to become a world champion and have the best in your role.
I mean, it's just the amazing thing about SKT, the organization to build the structure around these players so they can do this again and again.
Thank you. much-deserved trophy raised once again by our 2017 mid-season invitational champions, and the crowd, wild as ever, loud as ever, very pleased with the showing from both teams today. We have to remember that SK Telecom was challenged today. This did not come easily for them, and yet they fought through and achieved victory.
And even though SKT often makes it look easy, it's never easy. Everyone wants this just as much as SKT does, but time and time again, SKT showed they are the best.
And this just raises the question, how far does this team and this organization go? I mean, Bob Smith, you said perhaps a run that will never be matched again, but let's remember that this run's not over, right? They've just hit one milestone, and now it's about can they push forward. They'll be defending champions if they are to make it to the 2017 World Championships later this year.
It's the sort of run that should never happen, Dash. The game changes every meta. The meta has evolved, and SK Telecom have rolled with the meta, and that's why the domination is unprecedented.
And to me, to answer that question, you have to ask another. When does Faker and Koma retire? When do they, stop? Because it has to feel like these guys are so good and are so dominant that they may not stop winning until they choose to step down.
I mean, you forget how young Faker is as a player, right? Because he's been at that level of dominance for so long, as you mentioned, Jack, and it feels, in order to be there, the experience that he's acquired, the poise that he presents on stage and against adversity. Let's remember, he's focused the entire series here. That guy rises above all, does what is needed to be done to support his team in their quest for the championship, and hey, that's why he's on that stage every single time at the end of the turn.
And that poise had to be learned. He was such a young player, 17, when he raised the trophy in the Staples Center. Only now can he drink in North America. But when it comes to celebrations, however, the celebrations have come thick and fast over all these years.
Absolutely. Now, we'll be hearing from a number of the pros in the next few minutes. But until then, we get to talk about how SKT closed out this series.
Are you sure? The fans don't seem to want us to be talking.
I know, really. They're going to make our jobs difficult, but we got to push through.
Most of the fans still giving a standing ovation to SKT. They know what it means to have SKT win another championship and to witness their greatness in League of Legends, which is truly unprecedented. And they're just trying to get all they can out of this experience. We only got four games. They're going to try and make the duration five.
Yeah, I like it. But we have to reflect, too, on the team that challenged them here. We have to remember the achievement of G2 Esports here coming into today, let alone how far they pushed SKT in the series.
And I mean, to me, G2 really went above and beyond today, above and beyond the expectations of, the players and the analysts and the fans. And they did challenge SKT. Not only did they take a game, but they pushed them to the limit in multiple others. And I think that there's a lot to be said for that. And this team has really redefined themselves, this MSI, and going into Worlds, they will be a threat. They will be a team that people are looking to and respecting. They're no longer a joke.
Absolutely.
I mean, people talk about the gap, right? The gap is always a question. As a Korean caster, if I get interviewed, where's the gap at? Is it closing? I feel like I should get a personal sponsorship from the gap, given how much I have to talk about it. What we can say today is that the gap between SKT and G2, it was there. But it wasn't that big. Are we saying now SKT and Europe? No. But SKT and G2, there was actually a competitive series played here for at minimum the first three games. So that is a huge compliment to pay a team.
It's a bridgeable gap at this point.
A pretty long bridge.
We get to see the best team from every region come together here at MSI. And SKT, 2 years in a row now, has shown how much better they are than those teams. And the answer that these teams are going to have when they come to Worlds, these number one teams from all these regions, is what else can they add to their game? Because they were all the best of the best of their region, but that didn't necessarily translate. And I think G2, more than other teams, were able to focus on MSI even back in the spring split, trying to develop a playstyle that could at least compete with SKT, and they were able to do that here today.
And even within MSI, the growth that this team showed from day one, where they played, to today, it's like a completely different team. They improved, they learned, they adapted, and they showed that they can be at a much higher level than we had expected.
And let's go on an org level. Remember, we had IAM Cologne, IAM Katowice a few months ago. A lot of teams opted out of that. Jet lag, didn't want to show strategies. G2 went. It was admittedly in Europe, but they went there. They made the final. They got some international experience. They made the final. And now they're on the international stage again, with the infrastructure there again. So different from a year ago. And the adaptation and amount of poise they had was noticeable for this team.
Yeah, I had to check what all the noise is about. They're cheering Peanut getting set up for his interview for the past 2 minutes.
Yeah, it's been absolutely electric in this venue for the whole 2 weeks that we've been down here. We have to give our nod to the Brazilian crowd.
I love the fans. I mean, it's hilarious. It's like everywhere they count down the last 10 seconds. These guys count down the last 10 seconds to every minute, 30 minutes starting before the show. Like, the amount of excitement and energy in the building has been incredible.
I don't know, that looked cheer-worthy to me, Jack.
I just heard this while they did an interview with Peanut for the Brazilian crowd, so they're also cheering that.
That's why. We're only hearing ourselves in our headset right now, and then the roar of the crowd itself. You know, in a tournament, though, which felt so unpredictable, at least through the group stages, right, we had teams beating everyone in every which way, you know, not just triangles of wins and losses. I have to give credit to you guys here on the final day, getting your predictions correct. I want to extend that to all three of you. Well done.
We did.
Well done.
Yes.
He predicted it so long in advance, he brought props.
There it is, right?
Little do you know, he has props of all six teams with their tricolor.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, but again, I think that does speak to, again, the performance that G2 put up today, the fact that everyone did come in so definitively. We're talking about this tournament as the, is this going to be the